Good evening. Thank you all so much for being here for night one of the five-night tour of the Violoncelle Francophone, which is an exploration of music for cello and piano by French-speaking composers from around the world. This is a concert tour sponsored by a grant of the Montana Arts Council, which is a department of the state government. The first piece is by perhaps the most famous composer from France, Claude Debussy, who lived around the turn of the 20th century and is closely associated with the musical style of Impressionism. The next composer, Maurice Ohana, perhaps much less well known, also spent quite a lot of his career in France, but he was born in Morocco, which was at the time a colony or a protectorate of France. And this piece, Nocturne, is inspired by nighttime activities, and I think it represents another degree of evolution of the ideas of Impressionism that Debussy and other Impressionist composers of the early 20th century launched. Nocturne translates to noctuary, which is a ledger or an accounting of nighttime activities, sort of a log of things that occur on a given night. And so throughout this piece, via very different musical language and techniques from that of Debussy's time, you'll hear Ohana impressions the nighttime activities of some slightly foreboding scene.
Thank you.
Two pieces will be by French-speaking pedagogues of the 20th century. Nadia Boulanger, sort of in reverse order here, Nadia Boulanger is perhaps the most influential person on 20th century classical music that you may not have ever heard of. She was a composer and an especially influential professor of composition based in Paris. And her students include some of the, perhaps all of the most well-known names of composers in the 20th century. Elliot Carter, Virgil Thompson, Aaron Copland, Jean Francais, and the list goes on. Her impact is immeasurable, and it is a shame that her music, which is quite amazing, is not better known. Before we present her three pieces for cello and piano, we will play a sonata by a Haitian composer, Julio Racine, who was born in Haiti, studied music there and in the United States, before returning to Haiti, where he made a career as a composer, a performer, and teacher and conductor. So a massively influential figure in the Haitian musical community of the past several decades. He only recently passed away, and this piece, Sonata to Cynthia, was dedicated to his daughter, Cynthia, who is a cellist. So please enjoy Sonata Cynthia et trois pièces pour violoncelle et piano.
Thank you.
Thank you. for cello and piano, is a piece that Brian and I have been scheming for years to find a chance to perform together. It is one of the true treasures of 20th century repertoire for cello and piano, and it's one that offers a dazzling variety of expressive tones. It skips between jovial and frolicking to lyrical and somber on a turn of a dime throughout all four movements, and it's a real blast to play. It's a lot of fun to listen to. It's a lot of work to play. Poulenc collaborated on this piece with Fournier, one of the greatest cellists of the 20th century, and I'm not sure whether Fournier egged Poulenc on, pushing the technique more and more, or if Fournier was trying somewhat unsuccessfully to restrain him. But anyway, this is a piece that's so much fun to get to dive into, and I'm so grateful that Brian is able to be here to endeavor on this tour. So I hope that you enjoy the length of Chelsea.
Thank you. Thank you. 24 hours in Missoula has already been a really warm welcome. Thanks to Adam and thanks to the school of music here. Really, and a beautiful hall to play in. Embarrassment of riches. So, poison on the program contribution here is that I said, why don't we do some non-cello music? Why don't we do some songs, pop music and art song, transcribe it for cello. You know, cello is sort of the extension of the voice in the string section, right? So all of these songs are specifically chosen for the time right now and the program in mind, but Autumn by Foray is, I encourage you to look up all the lyrics after you go home, so I won't spell it out all now. But we have autumn scenes of melancholy walking amongst the hills where we are right now. We go to sort of pop music, post-war, Douce France, My Beloved France, could be heard, you know, popularized by a soldier away from home during the war. We have a new voice, Anivu, that is born in 94, postdoc at University of Chicago, where I'm from. Setting of a Verlaine text where we typically hear Foray or Debussy set this text, but we have a new take on this. And finally, our Madame Edith Piaf with The Crowd.